Here is the question. The production of food grain in 1000 ton and the year is mentioned to you. The 11th question is what? In the case of how many years was the production below the average production of the given year? So first you calculate the average production. So how you calculate the average value of each production? So you need to add all this production in the given year and divide that value by 6 because 6 year is given to you. So what you need to do is, you take this 100, 10, 80, 100, 130, 65 and 120. Divide this value by 6. So what you will get, 605, divide this value by 6. So what you will get,
100.83.
Okay. So this is the average production, 1000 ton. Okay. For this question. Now, how many years the production was below this? So you can easily visualize that there are 80 is below than this average 80. So in 1993 the average is below, 100 is also below this average 1008. So in 1995 also the average is below, and 65, this is also below this average. So it means there are 3 years where the production was below the average production of the given year. Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the first question. Okay. Now, again, I am telling this, ki before attack to any question, first you understood the data which is given to you. Interpret the data first. Then it will become very easy. And then second, what question asked to you. It is very, very important. If you read the question carefully, if you misunderstand the any of the new questions, if it is given to you, then it is difficult to calculate the right answer. Now, 12th question. Come to the 12th question. What was the percentage drop in production from 1996 to 1997? So, in 1996, the production was 130 in 1000 ton, and 1997 is 65. So, what was the production drop? You need to calculate. Calculate and give me the answer.
50, sir.
Okay.
50, sir.
Okay, very good. Many student give their reply, the answer is 50. Now I'm going to solve this problem. How you can solve this percentage drop? I also tell you about this, how you calculate the percentage decreases value. For that, you first take the positive difference in number in numerator, divide by, if you want to calculate the decrease value, then you take the maximum value between these two values. So the difference between 130 is maximum value, minus 65 is minimum value. This is a positive difference. And since decreases value, that means you take the maximum value in the denominator. So what we will get, 65 divided by 130, multiply this value by 100 because I need to calculate this value in percentage. This comes 1 by 2. And if you divide this value by 2, you will get 50%. So 50% drop in production from 1996 to 1997. Option B is the correct choice. Okay. Now I am moving to the 13th question. Please look at the 13th question and give me the answer. Everyone, please try.
Sir, 1995.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Rajaul Haq said 1995.
Shravan says 1995.
Okay. Good.
Sir, 1995.
Okay, dear.
1995,
sir. Okay, mute everyone, please. So, in which of the year was the production is 50% of the total production of 1993-1998 together. So, first you take, where is 1993? So, in 1993, the production was 80,000 and in 1998, the production was 120. So, first take the together value. Okay, total production in 1993 and 1998. So, in 1993, the production was 80,000 and here 120,000. Divide this value by 2 because you need to calculate the 50% of the value. So the total production was 200,000 and divide this value by 2. Why I'm dividing? Because I need to calculate the 50% of this value, and it comes 100,000 ton. And in which year it is equal to 100,000 ton? Look at this screen. In 1995, the production was 100. So my answer will be 1995. So in 1995 year was the production is 50% of the total production in 1993 and 1998 together. Very good. Well done. Now calculate the 14th value, please. Give me the answer. 14th.
120.
So please read the question carefully. What question asks from you, if the production in 1999, there is no year 1999, but it presumes that if it is asking if in 1999, the production in 1999 will be above the average production of the given year. So what was the average production of the given year? 100.8. So it means my in 1999, my production must be greater than 1008. Double zero. Okay, it must be greater than this. So what question asks, which is the following could be the minimum production in 99? Minimum. So just after this, the minimum value is C. Look at the screen. 100,900. Here 100,800. After this, the minimum value is asking. A is not a right answer because it is,
yes,
okay, it is less than this, is more. So it asking minimum production in 1999, so it could be what? 100,900. Yes or no? Tell me yes or no. Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, dear. Okay. So now moving to the 15th question. Please try, dear, everyone, the class. What was the approximate percentage increase in production? So you need to calculate percentage increase in production from 1993 to 1994.
So B, 40%.
B, okay.
40%.
Okay. So percentage increase from 1993 to 1994. So in 1993, the production was 80,000. In 1994, the production was 110,000 ton. Okay, so percentage increases means to say the difference, the positive difference between these two. So this is 110 minus of 80. And since I am calculating the increases value, so the minimum value I am putting in the denominator. Okay, so this is what 30 divided by 80, multiply this value by 100. This 00 gone. So 3 by 8 into 100. So 1 by 8 I know, 1 by 8 is 12.5. So if you multiply 12.5 into 3, you will get 37.5. So the answer will be 37.5, but it is asking the approximate percentage increase. What is the nearer option is here?
Okay,
is option B. But accurate answer will be what? 37.5% increases. Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this one is the question based on data interpretation. Whenever the bar graph is asking, but in bar graph, dear, this is single bar graph which is on the screen, but now I'm giving you the second bar graph problem where you have more than one bar. Okay, so this is the question. First you take the screenshot of this, everyone. If you don't write, please take the screenshot of this. Okay, so that you can practice at your home also. Those who not done this and there is in confusion, so you just do it by yourself at your home, okay, after the class. Now I'm moving to the combined bar graph problem. So here first important thing is read the graph carefully. Okay, so in this case the question is what? The study the following graph carefully and answer the question below it. So what it is mentioned, the graph shows the income and expenditure of a company over the year. So over the year means 1995, expenditure is given to you and income is given to you. Income is in blank line, blank bar, and expenditure is hatches line, this cross sectional area like type. Okay, so study 1 year. In 1994, the company income was 30 lakhs. रुपी द डेटा इज गिवन इन लैक्स 30 लैक्स एंड एक्सपेंडिचर इज वॉट 20 लैक्स. इन 1995 एक्सपेंडिचर इनकम वॉज 50 लैक्स एंड एक्सपेंडिचर वॉज 30 लैक्स. ओके लाइक वाइज दिस टेबल इज गिवन टू यू. ओके नाउ कम टू द 16th क्वेश्चन. सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम. ओके डियर 10 लैक. सो हियर इज द सोल्यूशन. क्वेश्चन आस्क वट इज द डिफरेंस इन द प्रॉफिट बिटवीन 1995 एंड 1996. सो इन 1995 फर्स्ट कैलकुलेट वट इज द प्रॉफिट इन 1995. सो दिस इज इनकम एंड दिस वन इज एक्सपेंडिचर. सो माई प्रॉफिट इन 1995 विल बी वॉट इनकम माइनस एक्सपेंडिचर. सो 50 माइनस 30 so it comes 20 lakh. So 20 lakh is profit in 1995. And what is profit in 1996? So in 1996 my profit was what? In 1996 my profit was 40 minus 30. So it comes 10 lakh. 10 lakh. So not 1995 it is 20 lakh, 1996 it is 10 lakh. And question asks find out the difference in profit. So difference in profit will be what? 20 lakhs minus 10 lakhs, so it will be 10 lakh. Very good. 10 lakh. So your answer will be 10 lakh. Okay. Now try this 17th question. Everyone, please.
3 years.
17th.
It's option 3.
3 years, sir.
3 years.
Okay. Okay. So in the case of how many years, was the income more than the average income of the given year? So first you calculate what is your average income. A company's average income. So income means 30, 50, this 30, 40, 60 and 60. First you add. So you will get 30 plus 50 plus 40 plus 60 plus 60. Divide this value. Yes. Give me the average value.
48.
The average value, 48. Is, average value 48. Is 48. So this is what, this is average income of the given year. And you need to find out how many years the income more than this. So income more than this means to say how many years the income is more than this. So this is 51, 60, second and this 60, where the income is more than 48. Otherwise you will get 30, 30 and 40, 30, 30 and 40 and it is less than. So it means the answer is 3. If the question asks, mention the year also, then you can say that in 3 year, in 1995, it is higher than the average income. 1997 was the answer and 1998 as well. Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
sir. Now try this this one, dear. 18th question. Try 18th question.
Option B.
33.3.
Yes, sir.
33.33.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I'm going to solve this third problem, 18th problem. So in 18th problem, what was the percentage increase you need to find out? In 1996 to 1997. So in 1996 to 1997, if you want to calculate, in 1996 expenditure. So in 1996 expenditure was 30, and in 1997 the expenditure was 40. So percentage increase. आपको निकालना है. So what is percentage increase? Difference. The positive difference between the number divided by in increases. You need to denominator will be the minimum of these two. That is 30 multiplies value by 100. So it comes 10 divided by 30 multiplied by 100. So you will get 1 by 3 multiplied by 100. So it means 33 divided by 1 by 3. Absolutely right. So your answer will be 33.33. Excellent. Now try this 19th question.
1997.
Excellent. Very good. So in this 19th question, the income in 1996 was equal to the expenditure of which of the following year? So in 1996, what is the income in 1996? So in 1996, the income was 40 lakh. Okay. Income was 40 lakh and find out equal to the expenditure of which of the following year. So this 40 is matched with which of the expenditure? This one. This one it is matched. Okay. So this is 1997. So it means 1997 is the right answer. Excellent. Now move to the 20th question. Try this.
1998.
In which of the following year was the profit the maximum? So you need to find out in which year the profit is maximum. So what is profit formula here? my profit formula here is income
minus expenditure
minus expenditure expenditure क्योंकि इतना खर्चा हो रहा है और इनकम मेरी ये है तो जो बचेगा वो मेरा प्रॉफिट होगा. सो इन 1994 डिफरेंस इज 10, इन 1994 डिफरेंस इज 10, इन 1995 डिफरेंस इज 20, ओके 50 माइनस 30, इन 1996 डिफरेंस इज 40 माइनस 30 मींस अगेन 10, एंड इन 1998 डिफरेंस इज व्हाट 60 माइनस 35 इट कम्स 25. सो आस्किंग द मैक्सिमम, ओके द मैक्सिमम प्रॉफिट विल बी इन 1998. वेरी गुड, सबको समझ में आ गया? यस और नो टेल मी.
यस सर.
यस सर.
यस सर.
ओके ओके. वर्षा अहमद आपको समझ में आया? वर्षा
यस.